up guys, Jesse here with JTech. Today I'm going to be showing you how air brake chamber comes apart and how you would replace the diaphragm inside of it. This is a 30-30 brake chamber here, which you can identify that by these inlets right here where the air goes for the rear and the spring brake and parking brake area. So as you can see, we already have the cage bolt in to cage this, the 1800 pound spring. So now what we're going to do here is we'll take our 9/16ths, or we'll take the ring that goes around the chamber to hold the service brakes up. That's what we're going to do right now. When you're doing this, you want to make sure that everything is caged so that you don't have any safety problems. As you can see, we already have the service brake side already caged in with our vice grips here. Because if you don't, the spring will cause it to fly off. Loosen almost the one side almost all the way off, and then take the other side completely off. Keeps your ring together and makes it easy for you taking it apart. There it is. You have your service brake side, you have your 30-30 diaphragm. With your diaphragm, you want to check to see if it has any cracks, breaks, splits, dry rotted, anything that could go bad with it. As you can see, this is a brand new one, so we don't have any problems with it. So here is the side that you would have your parking brake on, because this is where your 1800 pound spring is. We have it caged because it is very deadly and can kill somebody if it were to pop off. So now, if you're rebuilding one, you would replace just that. And now what we're gonna do is we'll put it back together. You wanna make sure everything on these diaphragms are lined up properly, so that when you put it all back together, it's sealed and it's airtight. You want to take your ring and you want to feed it on there and make sure everything is lined up and as secure as possible, because it's got to catch both sides of the lip, of this gold colored side and this iron colored side. Then we want to put our bolt in and tighten everything back up the way it's supposed to be. So we got that one secure, now we want to go to this side that's loose and we want to tighten it up all the way. And tighten the other side, make sure everything's secure. And then you can take your vice grips off. Have your spring brake chamber back together. Now we're going to take it over there in just a minute and I'll show you how this cage bolt works. Alright guys, we're back here. Just want to show you something real quick. So we have our two inlets here. One inlet runs the service side, so when you press the brake pedal in the truck, it runs this side. This side runs the parking brake side on your PP valve. Now what we're going to do here is we're going to do this a little bit unorthodox way. The best way to do is maybe have an adapter or something you can use to test these. But we're just going to use this blower right here. What we're going to do is we'll put this blower in here, we're going to hold down on it, and we're going to open this valve. Then we're going to loosen it, turn it out, and there's our cage bolt. Now this will be loud. So here we have our cage bolt. So the cage bolt has two ears and a nut that runs the whole length of it. So now these two ears fit inside of the hole here. Now you won't be able to see in there, but inside the hole it has the female end of this side. And the female end takes the male in, you put it in there, and it locks in. Easiest way to cage these things is just give it a little bit of air. If it's still hooked up to the truck, push it in, lock your brakes in, turn the brakes off of me, stick your cage bolt in there, and tighten it down as fast as you can. Make sure you want to do it correct, because if this thing goes flying out, it has the ability to seriously injure or kill somebody. This thing has an 1800 pound spring, and this thing's flying at as fast as a bullet. Now, I showed you how to rebuild it, how to check your diaphragm. That's pretty much in a gist of how to do it. Besides that, hope y'all have a good day. Thank you for watching, and I'm Jesse with JTech.